Hi, this is GEMINI DHAR. I'm a Take Charge expert and welcome to 2019. Don't you want to make your 2019 something awesome? And yes, I have an awesome guy with me all the way from the UK. We both are authors and we share the passion to transform lives and of course make a difference in this world. So we have Baiju Solanki with us and Baiju is going to share some amazing tips with you to change the game, like his book.
Change the game. Thank you so much for your time, GEMINI. We're in Bombay at the moment. We are in Bandra. So I'm here on a trip and I've been invited to one of your meetings. Really excited about it. So I'm an author, coach, psychologist, author of this book called Change Your Game. It's all about how we can understand that sometimes we as individuals are okay, but the game that we're playing is not the right one.
So it's more or less something similar to my Take Charge 5X formula. I talk about formulas and discovering formulas that can work for you.
Yep.
And you talk about changing the game.
Yep.
So I really want to have your insights into what can we do, what my audience can learn from you today. So the
premise I work from is that we as individuals are perfect. There's nothing wrong with us per se. However, if we're not getting what we want in life, you're not playing the right game. You know, if you play cricket, you have to use a cricket bat, right? If your opinion, what I want to use a tennis racket to play cricket, you're not going to win at cricket.
So
right?
Applying the right tool for the right thing, right?
Right tool for the right thing. And also, your opinion really has no bearing. Sometimes our opinion gets in the way of success because we can say, well, that's the way I've been taught, or I've been brought up this way, or you might do it that way, but I don't. And it's not based on any fact or any evidence of what you... how you're going to get successful, but it's just an opinion. So in the book, Change Your Game, I talk about three games. There's three games that we play. And the first game is the inner game. So what we talk about is the mindset. More about the context you live your life. So how you turn up, what your being is, your attitudes, your thoughts, your
beliefs,
your belief systems, and what belief systems aid you on what beliefs don't aid you, your attitude. So, and it's a constant thing, you know, sometimes, I have a certain attitude at a certain time, certain point in time, and it doesn't work. It's like, who are you being all the time that if I was a fly on the wall in your house, I would more or less say the same individual that I see outside.
True.
Yeah, there's certain situations you've got to act appropriately, I get that, but your mindset and your context you live your life is the same. So in the book I talk about there's an inner game we play and how you conquer that inner game. The second game is the game plan. And what I mean by that is the roadmap. So say, let's take cricket for example, is you choose 11 players, but the 11 players you choose will be dependent on the pitch, the opposition, you know, your strengths, how many batsmen you want, how many bowlers, spinners, etc. So there's a strategy, then you execute.
In real life, it's something like circumstances.
So what's the roadmap? What's the strategy? What's the thing that you want to create over the next year, 2 years? And what's the roadmap you're creating? So most people don't have a game plan. They wake up.
They live life the way it is. They want to just be in the present and don't want to plan for the future.
It's good to be in the present, but not good, without a plan.
It is like a whole package. You can't just have one aspect of your life and expect the life to be, you know, something extraordinary.
Yeah, you've got to do the work. And sometimes we look at other people who are extraordinary, we think, wow, they got it easy, or they must
have
paced up, or they got lucky.
They have got their formulas right, I believe so, and like you said, their game plan is somewhere.
But what we don't know is the blood and sweat behind the scenes. You don't see the blood and sweat. Like, you watch me and Gemini, we're all talking this and that, nice glasses, nice suit, and we think everything's good. It's not. You don't know what's behind the scenes.
I think the real work is not in front of the camera. The real work that we do is when we are with people, when we are talking and we are spreading the ideas that we believe in. And a lot of people look at us as like, I mean, what are you saying? This is something everybody knows, you know.
Mm.
But the moment you apply what different kind of perceptions that you gather and those that suit you, that make the whole difference.
It makes the whole difference. Yeah. And then we move on to the third game that I talk about in the book. And the third game is the outer game. And we're talking about actions, but more specifically, not just actions, but the consistent and the persistent actions you take day in, day out, hour by hour. You know, show me someone's habits and I'll show you how successful they are. It's as simple as that. Because the thing that you do more often, more habitually, will have an impact on what you do. But most people live their day reactionary. They react to things. They react to the day. They react to a situation. They react to a request. So they don't have, like, this is how I'm going to be. These are my boundaries. This is who I'm going to be. And when you have a request come in from a client or an associate, then you say, okay, if you've got a roadmap, you can say, well, does this request match my roadmap?
True.
If it's yes, then you respond to it. If it doesn't, then it's easy to say no, or easy to say not now. But a lot of people feel, I don't know when to say no, because they don't know their own...
They're obliged to please people, and in that journey, they end up, deviating from their path. And that's very sad, because there are some very, very extraordinary and very, very talented people who get detracted just because they got the wrong kind of environment.
That's it, yeah. So in the book, Change Your Game, whoop, there we are. Change Your Game, I talk about those three games, the inner game, the game plan, and the outer game. And then I talk about 56 ways that you can implement those figures. And once you start to understand there is a game, there's a game of life, and you understand those rules, there's universal rules, independent of your opinion, you start to win. You start to win at what you want.
So overall, 2019 can be a game changer for you. Watch out for Baiju's book. It's available on Amazon. It's a bestseller also.
I got him
today because we met a couple of times, and I really believe that each individual brings in something new into your life. So we got Baiju on our show today, and he shared some amazing insights. Let us know in the comment section, what do you think about it? Have you read his book? Do you know more about him? If you want to connect with him, you can check him on Instagram, Facebook.
If you Google my name, Baiju Solanki, you'll see all my stuff.
So thank you for watching, and thank you, Baiju, for sharing something amazing with us.
Thank you. Take care.
Bye.